What if I told you that you not only inherited your mother's eyes or your dad's chin, but you may have inherited your Grandpa Barney's stress? Hey everyone, it's Natalia Reagan, guest hosting again for D News. Life. Life isn't easy, and it appears the hardships from past generations may have a lasting effect on future generations. This idea that our current experiences, life choices, and environment could directly affect the genes of our descendants is called epigenetics. And the new research has found that the offspring of Holocaust survivors have altered stress hormones, or cortisol. Cortisol is an adrenal hormone that helps people cope with stress, aka maintain homeostasis. When an individual is stressed, cortisol helps regulate various changes in the body. These changes include fluctuations in blood sugar, immune responses, fat, protein, carbohydrates metabolism to maintain glucose, blood pressure, anti-inflammatory actions, and central nervous system activation. So let's just say cortisol is incredibly important to the body. So when researchers compared stress hormones in Holocaust survivors to those in the Jewish community who did not endure the Holocaust, researchers discovered they had lower levels of cortisol. And those individuals suffered from PTSD had even lower levels of cortisol. Researchers also discovered the Holocaust survivors were producing less of the enzyme to break down cortisol, which made sense given that this allowed liver and kidney functions to operate with lower glucose levels during times of starvation, something all too common during the Holocaust and Nazi occupation. Those who were younger during the Holocaust had the lowest levels of cortisol and produced the lowest amount of enzyme to break it down. When researchers looked at the cortisol levels of the children of Holocaust survivors, they found something disturbing. Like their parents, the kids had lower levels of cortisol. However, they had higher than average levels of the enzyme used to break it down. In a typical pregnancy, the placenta has higher levels of the cortisol-busting enzyme to protect the fetus. But if Holocaust survivors had lower levels of this enzyme, that would mean more cortisol would reach the fetus. So the fetus reacted by upping their enzyme protection. This made their offspring more likely to suffer from PTSD and susceptible to other illnesses brought on by unmanaged stress, such as hypertension and obesity. When researchers looked at the stress-related gene, they saw epigenetic tags were found in both Holocaust survivors and their offspring. This study is the first of its kind to discover that someone's stress and environment can directly affect their children before they were even conceived. These findings are revolutionary because it's been long accepted that DNA was the only way to transmit genetic information from generation to generation. But research shows that the environment indeed plays a role in modifying genetic information, as chemical tags are actually attached to our DNA that serve to turn specific genes on and off. Essentially, at the genetic level, our biology is preparing our descendants to thrive in the current environment. And in this particular case, it would have been the incredibly hostile environment that was the Holocaust. This isn't the first study that researchers have looked to Holocaust survivors to understand epigenetics. Researchers have already discovered that stress experience while in utero can have lasting effects on an individual's health. During the 1944 hunger winter in the Netherlands, pregnant women experienced extreme stress and starvation. Their offspring were later studied and found to have suffered from higher instances of diabetes, obesity, and cardiovascular disease than those born to mothers who had not endured the hunger winter. And girls born to women during this time had an above average risk of developing schizophrenia. The link between stress, cortisol levels, disease, and its propensity to be passed down to future generations illustrates that our environment is far more significant when it comes to our health and the health of our offspring. Similar studies have been carried out in mice. Researchers exposed mice to the scent of cherry blossoms, with simultaneously shocking them with electric shock. Mice were trained to fear the smell, and their offspring were found to also fear the scent of cherry blossoms. They appeared to inherit the memory and fear. This research, coupled with the altering of stress hormones in Holocaust survivors and their descendants, means there is a great deal to still learn about the science of epigenetics. And with that goal in mind, here's a video from Trace about how your mom's stress could be passed on to you.
Researchers at McGill in Canada found pregnant mothers who were without power and followed them and their offspring for 13 years to see how it affected them. Turns out, the North American ice storm of 1998 affected the kids' DNA.
So what kind of stress will you pass on to your future generations? Let us know in the comments below and subscribe to D News for more videos every day of the week.